Steve Pantuso. Welcome to the show again.
Thank you, Terry. Great to be with you, as always.
As always. Well, you and your great staff do such a great job, and you're always very, very anxious and supportive to get information out that folks have for you and the transportation industry in America. And you know the only person I can go to get this information is Pete Pantuso. So,
I hope that's true.
More than true, Pete. More than true. So let me go ahead and ask some questions that folks have, and
sure.
I'll let you kind of answer the way that you feel that we need the information from your great association. And the first one is really a good one, Pete, and I think that people need to know that we've been doing ABA marketplaces for quite a while now, and most of it's been virtual. I think that you need to kind of comment on how that's been working out.
Well, the virtual has been working great. I mean, nothing beats face-to-face, obviously, and we've been doing marketplaces for over 40 years now, and it's exciting to bring everybody together and where we can see them and talk face-to-face and see how they're doing, how their business is. But, you know, we did our virtual appointments this year. We did 2 weeks' worth, actually, one set of appointments at the end of May and one at the beginning of June just to spread the operators out a bit. And they went really, really well. We got a lot of feedback, got a lot of great positive feedback. We had almost 650 people participating in the virtual events. And we heard nothing but good things. But everybody definitely wants to get back to a face-to-face meeting. We're going to do that in Grapevine, Texas, just outside of the Dallas-Fort Worth airport area. And we're going to do it January 8th through the 11th, coming up in 2022. And I can't wait. I can't wait to see everybody again. I mean, most of us haven't seen one another for at least a couple of years. And I guarantee it will be another fabulous show where business gets done. More business takes place at this group travel show than any other show in the country, any other domestic show. And so we're excited to bring everybody back.
Can't wait myself. I want to tell you, Pete, this is between you and me. That's all I hear. We like to have a chance to contact folks with the virtual program, but boy, I can't wait until we get together person to person. And so absolutely, folks are waiting and waiting and cannot tell you that's going to be a special moment in time for everybody.
Definitely will. People really want to see each other and find out about, you know, not only about business, but they want to find out about their kids and their families and how they're doing. It's such a relationship business. And you can do it, obviously, over the phone. You can do it via Zoom, but it's just not the same as being in person.
The marketplace, listeners, is almost like coming back to family because it's been years of just meeting folks, and that's the place you go when you want to try and get business taken care of for group travel, group tourism, the whole area of just groups and transportation. So it's just like coming home, I think, more than anything else, Pete. And that's what makes it so special. Anyway, we've got questions.
Right.
We've got some questions for you, and I think probably the best one I think we come up with is coming out of the pandemic. We've had some questions of folks wanting to know what will that mean for the group travel industry for going into the future for transportation issues.
Yeah, so great questions. You know, there's issues we're dealing with now and issues we're going to be dealing with down the road over the next couple of years. So a couple of things right now. I mean, people need to remember that there is a federal mandate to wear masks if you're traveling on intercity buses. Those would be city to city like Greyhound, et cetera. But the CDC currently has a mask policy for all other bus requirements. So anybody who's on a charter bus, according to the CDC, should be wearing a mask. Now, that's in effect until we don't know when. They don't have a review date. And the CDC has no enforcement authority. So, you know, take that for what it's worth, because we're getting more questions about that than almost anything else. when I think about, you know, where the group industry is for the rest of the year, it's still going to be a little bit challenged. And I've talked to a lot of operators who, you know, their fall is normally their second busiest season. And they're telling me that the fall is good, but it's not anywhere close to where it would have been in 2018 or 2019. And part of that reason is the planning process. As you know, group tour planning takes a while. I mean, those fall trips should be planned early in the year, January, February, March. And when that planning window should have been open, we were in the peak of pandemic and a lot of uncertainty. So a lot of that planning for this fall didn't happen. On top of that, what we're hearing is, you know, the shortage of labor. So bus companies are challenged trying to find drivers right now. Hotels, restaurants, everybody else is challenged trying to find personnel to handle groups coming in the door. And so all of that fitting together is going to be a little softer fall than I think we'd hoped for. But at the same time, I'm hearing next spring is just gangbusters. I mean, the phone is literally ringing off the hook. And again, the challenge is going to be, you know, are there going to be enough buses for everybody? We've seen during the pandemic, a quarter of the bus companies go out of business. Mostly, wow. I would say, smaller companies, smaller fleets. We've seen a lot of equipment that's sitting along the side of the road that can't be sold because it's got no value. We also saw repossessions of buses take place. And again, this driver shortage is like nothing we've ever seen before. I'm talking to operators every day who tell me that they've got more work than they have drivers for. They've got buses sitting that they just can't run because they don't have enough drivers. So, you know, in the short term, that's going to be a challenge. And so I would say anybody who's planning a trip, wanting to put a group together for next year, you better get that bus locked down sooner rather than later and look for those shoulder seasons when you can maybe move the group out of the peak times, because it's going to be a challenge.
You know, that's always a good tip to make sure that you're prepared for the future. You've got to make sure that, you know, everything is covered. And that will be a challenge in the future, Pete. I really agree with you as far as the availability of motor coach transportation. So that's a good tip. Pete has a lot of great tips, and the ABA has a lot of great tips. And what are some of the plans does the ABA have other than the marketplace to help support the group travel industry in general?
Yeah, you know, we on a regular basis, we do webinars. I mean, we did over 100 webinars last year. I don't know exactly the number that we're at this year. I don't think we're quite at 50, but you know, we're doing a webinar almost every week, at least every other week, but more frequently than that. Most of them are available not just for the members, but for anybody to be a part of, and most of them are also online where people can find them after the fact if they want to go back and listen to them. So education is clearly a big part of what we do. Bringing together, obviously, the group travel industry and every segment of it, whether it's motor coach, tour operators, travel members, and other suppliers. We've got a lot of education for motor coach companies that's going to take place throughout the year. We're just in the middle of finishing up our safety conference that was actually, because it was virtual, we were able to spread it out over a longer period of time, over a couple of months. That's wrapping up. And then we've got on our website, too, two really great pieces. One on the preparedness for the pandemic and coming out of the pandemic. So looking at cleanliness procedures and things that should continue, I hope, long after the pandemic is over. I mean, the processes of cleaning and sanitizing coaches should be something that sticks with this industry, you know, well after the pandemic, just as a good business practice and something that the customer is going to always want to be looking for. And then we've also got information on, you know, closures at national parks or restrictions at national parks. You know, we had a lot of success just recently in getting four of the iconic Western parks to open up their doors to full motor coaches. Up until a month ago, Grand Canyon, Grand Teton, Yosemite, and Yellowstone had all said that you could only have 10 people on a bus coming in, and that included the driver and the escort. That meant 8 paying customers could only come in on a bus. That just wasn't going to happen.
Wow.
So all that's on our website.
And what is that website, Pete Pantuso?
That is www.buses.org.
And what can you find on that website?
And Everything. And the best, I think one of the best features is the chat function. So, you know, if you can't find something or if you're looking for something specific, the chat's going to pop up as soon as you log in. Just type it in, type in your question, and we'll get back to you usually within a matter of minutes. And even overnight, we've got people that are often responding to it on the staff here. So, yeah, if you can't find it, it's on there somewhere. Just let us know. We'll help you find it.
It's a good reason to be a member of the ABA listeners, but more importantly, I think just have a chance to talk with your great staff. They're so friendly, so outgoing, and they're so willing to help. It's a pleasure to do that, and you almost want to say thank you and to each of them when you have a chance to meet them at the marketplace, because they are there also to help support you and the marketplace and when it happens. And I think Pete and your staff, I want to commend you for trying to get fresh information out to the group travel industry, but more importantly, just an opportunity to just be a friend, to help in any way that you possibly can.
Well, and I can tell you, they all love serving our members, serving the customers. You know, I've got staff that have been here almost 30 years, and I think our shortest term staff person's been here a couple of years now, and you know, it runs the gamut all the way in between. So they're here because they absolutely love what they do and love the people that they get to work with every single day.
Any plans now that we're getting the final and the good announcement that Grapevine is the destination for Marketplace that you need to let listeners know about?
Well, I think there's a couple of things that are exciting about Grapevine. We've been there before. It's been quite a few years. I think, gosh, over 10 years maybe since we've done a Marketplace there. But it's such a great destination. We're at the Gaylord Hotel. It is literally right outside the gates of DFW Airport, so it's easy for everybody to get to. The city of Grapevine is an incredibly special place. It's a small town within a giant state, so you feel like, you know, it's a little local homecoming place when you go down Main Street and see all the shops and the restaurants and visit the wineries. And it's an incredible little town, like I said, within a great big place. It's something you don't normally think of as being that fabulous and that close to Dallas and Fort Worth and to the airport. So we're going to have a great marketplace. As you said earlier, people are excited to get back together and see each other once again. And everybody I talk to in the association, all of our members just are chomping at the bit to get together again. There really haven't been many shows that have taken place. In fact, there haven't been any that have taken place really in the last 12 months other than virtual shows. So this will be the big one for everybody to reunite, start building business again. And that's what Marketplace is all about. It's about business. We have a lot of fun doing it, but it's about business going forward and finding those groups again and finding those special places to bring your groups to.
A couple of things that I think you need to know about Grapevine, Texas, listeners. It's built itself as the Christmas capital of Texas, and they do have a great, great selection of wonderful things to see and do in the town of Grapevine. But the town itself gives itself away, Grapevine. So they have a huge wine festival every year, one of the top ABA events, I think it's been recognized for. It is truly a special place. But listeners, listen to what I say this. If you want to really go and have a unique experience at this marketplace at Grapevine, Texas, the Gaylord Texan, Pete, if I'm going to guess a hotel that I would recommend that would represent Texas the very best, it has to be the Gaylord Hotel.
Oh my God, there's no question about it. I mean, from the minute you walk in the door, if you were blindfolded and flew somebody anywhere from the world and landed them in that lobby, you would know that you were in Texas. I mean, it's just a fabulous, fabulous place.
Well, you get a Texas welcome, I can assure you that, Pete, being from Texas myself, and it's a wonderful opportunity for a great kickoff. Again, let's get those dates out for folks and give them the website for more information. And Pete, it's great to talk with you again, and I want to thank you for being on the show. And I can't tell you what a joy it's going to be for folks to get together and say hello to each other again.
Absolutely. Well, always great to talk to you, Terry. I look forward to seeing you in January. And those dates, just so you show up on the right dates, are January 8th through 11th. again, at the Gaylord Texan Hotel in Grapevine, Texas. And if people want information, again, they can go to our website, buses.org. They'll find information on Marketplace right at the top of the website. They click on that. Registration opens, I believe, off the top of my head, July 8th. So it's going to open up fairly soon. They can sign up anytime. But the sooner the better, because again, it's going to be a busy show this year. Really, really busy.
Pete Pantuso, great to talk with you. Thanks for being on the show.
Thanks, Terry. Great to be with you.